Hello friends, Ragini here. Now it is mock test 26 related to satellite communication. Now this I have already told the question in last slide that a satellite link uses different frequencies for receiving and transmitting in order to avoid interference between its powerful transmitted signal and weak incoming signal. That's I have already told you and I have explained you deeply. Now so the right option is D here. The right option is here D. Next question. In a geostationary satellite communication system, a message signal is transmitted from an earth station from an via an uplink to a satellite, amplified in a transponder on board the satellite and then transmitted via downlink to another earth station. Okay, the most popular frequency band for satellite communication. First of all, you should be aware that what is a geostationary satellite communication and what this you I have told you in the last slide, what is a transponder. And geostationary means geo is stationary. Stationary means which is something constant, which is still. So geostationary means a worldwide network of operational meteorological satellite which is used to provide visible and infrared images of the earth station and atmosphere. Okay, first of all, this is very clear. Next, that geostationary satellites stand still in the sky. They lie in the same plane on equator. Geostationary satellite lie on same plane as equator. Geostationary actually is orbiting the earth once every 24 hours, same time it takes to make one rotation. You know the satellite revolves around the earth. So geostationary satellites are always positioned as if they're standing still in the sky. They lie on the same plane as equator and they're used to provide the visible and infrared images of the earth's surface and the atmosphere. So the most popular frequency, these are the options, uplink, downlink. So the most probable option will be the right option, C option. That is C band. As I have already told you, there are some bands. L is C, X, Q, K, K. L is 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 18, 18 to 24, 18 to 26 and 26 to 26 to 40, these frequencies are in gigahertz. So, mainly the popular frequency band for satellite communication is C band, 6 gigahertz for uplink and 4 gigahertz for downlink. This we will discuss in our further slides because, first of all, you should be aware of the bands L, S, C, X, Q, K, K. Okay, so C band is most probably used. Okay, now. And transponder are like repeaters in the sky. They are used to receive the signal that has been transmitted from the earth station throughout the space. And then they receive the signals and then they amplify it, boost it, and then regenerate it and then retransmit at a different under frequency to the earth station. Okay. Now, next question is, as per WARC 1979, what do you mean by WARC? First of all, this is very important terminology here. WARC. What is this WARC? WARC stands for World Administration. I am writing the full form. World Administrative Radio Conference. World Administrative Radio Conference. Okay, there are three portions of the shortwave radio spectrum which is used by licensed radio operators for amateur use. Why? This WARC 1979 allocation means there are three portions. There are actually three portions of shortwave radio spectrum. Shortwave radio spectrum which is used by licensed radio operators for amateur use. Now what is amateur means? Amateur means one who uses equipment at an amateur radio station to engage in two-way personal communication with other operators at some other radio frequency. Okay, means So this, as per WARC 1979 allocation, the commercial communication satellites use bandwidth of 500 megahertz. This you should learn this, because this is certified bandwidth. This is a standardized bandwidth which is generally used. Bandwidth is the range of the frequency which the signal occupies. Okay, so WARC stands for World Administrative Radio Conference. Actually, this is the three portions of shortwave radio spectrum which is used by the licensed radio operators for amateur use, who uses equipment at some amateur radio station there, where there is having some two-way personal communication with other operators at some radio frequencies. Okay, so this you should learn. In satellite communication, Faraday rotation is caused by, no, it is neither caused by plasma frequency, it is something different. Non-Gaussian nature of uplink, no. The noise is always Gaussian in nature. Ionospheric reflections that occur multiple times, no. This is Earth's magnetic field. Now, what is this Faraday rotation? Faraday rotation means, Faraday is an rotation, is an interaction between light and magnetic field in a medium. You should be knowing that this Faraday rotation is an interaction. Actually, it is an interaction between light and magnetic field. Magnetic field means B is equal to mu H. Magnetic field in a medium. So Faraday rotation is caused by left hand circularly polarized and right hand circularly polarized at slightly different speeds. When a plane polarized satellite signal, okay, polarization is what? The orientation of the electric field vector in the space. Okay, so when a plane polarized satellite signal is incident on ionosphere, which is permeated by Earth's magnetic field, it splits into ordinary and extraordinary waves. You can say that when a plane polarized satellite signal, okay, it is incident on the ionosphere. What is ionosphere? Ionosphere is high concentration of ions and the free electrons that reflect radio waves. Okay. And its height is around 80 to 1000 kilometer above the Earth's surface. Okay. So, whenever a plane polarized satellite signal is incident or it falls on the ionospheric layer, which is permeated by the Earth's magnetic field, it splits into two waves. Ordinary and extraordinary waves. This is ordinary and this is extraordinary waves. Modes, or you can say modes. The patterns. This is known as Faraday rotation, which is half the phase difference of the two circularly polarized characteristic modes. Okay. So in satellite communication, Faraday rotation is mainly caused by the Earth's magnetic field, and it is mainly an interaction between the light and the magnetic field in a medium. Whenever a plane polarized satellite signal falls or is incident on the ionospheric layer, which is nothing but the high concentration of ions and the free electrons, then it splits into two waves or two ordinary and extraordinary modes, which is known as Faraday rotation. And it is half the phase difference of two circularly polarized characteristic modes. Okay, so the right answer is the Earth's magnetic field. Next question, the frequency range for satellite communication. Always remember that frequency range for satellite communication is always in gigahertz, because it is a wireless communication also. 1 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. You know VLF, LF, MF, HF, you know, there are certain bands that you should remember of. VLF, LF, MF, HF, VHF, UHF, SHF, EHF. Okay, so VLF means very low frequency, 0 to 3 kilohertz. LF means 3 to 30 kilohertz. Medium frequency means 30 to 300 kilohertz. High frequency means 300 kilohertz to 3 megahertz, or you can say 3 to 30 megahertz. This is around 3 to 30 megahertz. 30 megahertz to 3 gigahertz is the ultra high frequency. Super high frequency is 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz. Extra high frequency is 3 to 30 gigahertz. Okay. So, generally, we can say you have to remember these all frequency ranges: very low frequency, medium frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, extra high frequency. Extra high frequency is around 3 to 30 gigahertz. Okay. Now next, the different access methods which permit many satellite users to operate in parallel through a single transponder without interfering with each other is FDMA, TDMA, CDMA. Again, this is an important question. Always remember that TDMA is never used in satellite communication. TDMA access cannot permit many satellite users to operate in parallel. Why? Because every user can transmit data, can transmit its information only in some fixed time slot. Multiple access techniques, multiplexing, where there is a common use of the, where the same channel is used by the different users. Okay, this is multiplexing. Now, when I talk about that different access method which permit many satellite users to operate in parallel through a single transponder without interfering with each other, then it will be FDMA, it will be FDMA, and it will be CDMA. That means the option B is the right answer, because FDMA means that the each particular user has been assigned a different frequency slot where he or she can use his assigned data to transmit within that particular frequency slot. And CDMA is a code division multiple access which uses spread spectrum technologies, which is used in order to avoid interference. It provides jamming. It jams the signal so that the other user may not detect the signal if there is the communication between two parties. And it is actually a spread spectrum technology. It is used for wide bandwidth. So there is a certain code that has been assigned, which is only decoded at the receiver side, which is only known to the another receiver. No. Okay. And so that, which is only known to the authorized user. And it then prevents the signal not to reach the other unauthorized user. So TDMA means we have to transmit the signal or data or information only within some fixed time slot. We cannot use it in parallel. So FDMA and CDMA are used. Consider the following statements for multiple access system in a satellite earth station. Access to the same repeater subsystems and same RF channel is possible. Yes, this is absolutely right statement. Frequency division multiple access is used. Yes. Several carriers are not amplified by same TWT. False. TWT is what? Major advantage of TWT is wide bandwidth. Wide bandwidth. Okay, TWT is traveling wave tube amplifier. This you have already studied in microwave. Its operating frequency range is 300 MHz to 50 GHz. Okay, so the right option will be 1 and 2. Okay, so that means in a satellite earth station for multiple access system where the same channel is being used by multiple users, there should be an access, there should be a reach to the same repeater subsystems and same RF channel is possible. Yes, we can use the same channel by multiple users in order to transmit the data. FDMA is also used, but yes, several carriers are also amplified by the same TWT. Yes, in satellite we use TWTAs, we use LNAs, we use SSPAs. Okay, so we will discuss it in more detail in our upcoming slides. But till then, first of all, you should be aware of these questions, these MCQs, which generally come in the competitive exams. Okay, that much knowledge I have given to you so that first of all, you should be aware what are the questions, what are the options. And first of all, you get aware of the questions with the different options. I will tell you each and everything in the upcoming slides. I'm not telling you everything in detail, otherwise you will get bored very easily. So let me focus on the question with the particular solution. Only then you will be, your knowledge can be extended. Thank you. If you like my channel, and kindly share and subscribe. So thank you. And